It's time to cook like a chef. Are you one of those who do not have time to go for grocery shopping or maybe always confused what to cook during busy weeknight after a long day of work? Let Blue Apron take all this headache by making your weeknight evenings hassle-free with wonderfully planned out meal menu just like a restaurant style. Not only just for busy weeknight, but I think it's perfect for special moments or occasions, such as it could be your anniversary or Valentine, or it could be even family celebration. Blue Apron is a subscription recipe delivery service that delivers all the fresh ingredients and recipe you need to create a chef quality meal at home.
Perfect pre-portioned ingredients, so there's no waste. And look at the bottom. Comes with the two big huge ice packs to keep everything fresh.
And the great news is that Blue Apron is giving away two complimentary meals to first 50 viewers on their first Blue Apron order. Hurry in, click on the link provided under this video description to get your two meals for free. 50 is a big number. Who knows, you might be one of those. I thought of trying out Blue Apron just because I love to learn variety of cuisine recipes.
Lot of options to choose from. You can go by cuisine or the particular diet that you are following. I follow vegetarian diet, and I'm so surprised that they have tons of vegetarian recipes even to choose from. No wonder recipes never repeated in the same year. Choose delivery day that best fits your schedule. You can even skip or cancel anytime.
So without any further ado, let's start cooking. The first one I'm going to make is a roasted spaghetti squash. Recipe cards are just awesome.
On one side it has ingredients with the picture of the finished product, and at the back of it all the steps that you have to follow.
I can keep them for later use even. Heat the oven to 450 degrees Fahrenheit. So to prepare roasted spaghetti squash, here I have lined up the ingredients. Now you must be thinking, I said roasted squash spaghetti, but there's no spaghetti in the ingredients. So basically, we are going to learn today how to make spaghetti out of squash. Wash and dry the fresh produce. Using a sharp, sturdy knife, carefully halve the squash lengthwise. Drizzle the cut sides with olive oil and season with salt and pepper. And then arrange the squash halves cut side down and drizzle the skin sides with olive oil as well. Fill the pan with 1/4 inch of water. And I'm going to roast for about 30 minutes or until the cut sides are tender. While squash is baking, mince garlic, chop onion fine. It's been 35 minutes and ready to take out squash out of the oven. And it's super hot right now. Let it cool down slightly. While squash is cooling down, I'm going to prepare rest of the ingredients. And now I'm going to cut mushrooms roughly. Be sure to wash all the fresh produce. All right, done with garlic, onion and mushroom. I'm going to put that on the side. And I'm going to work on squash. Now, this job looks like a little challenge to me because I have never done it. But I'm going to follow the tips and tricks provided by Blue Apron. I drain out water, so there's no water inside. Turn them over. And it says that using the large spoon, scrape out and discard the seeds and the pulp. I can already see some spaghetti already here. Alright, so next it says gently scoop the flesh out of the skin in one large piece. Okay, look at that. Cool. I'm loving this. Alright, so I'm going to do the same for this one. Alright, next it says using a fork or your hands, gently break the flesh into long, thin strands, which is pretty much so easy. You can see that you can do this with your hands even, and I can see the nice spaghettis. No need to use fork even. Wow, I'm totally amazed. Seriously, because I have never done cooking like this. I always try to find easy way to cook, but this sounds like so much fun to me. You can do this with your kids and they will feel so proud doing this kind of chores. I am missing my kids because I'm sure they could have helped me with this. Look at this. Okay, I'm going to put this on the side. Wash my hands. And now let's look at what is the next step. I need to make the sauce. Heat up 2 teaspoons of olive oil. When the oil is nice and hot, add onion, minced garlic. Give it a quick stir. Add salt as per your taste. Add mushroom. And cook until onion and mushroom is tender. Meanwhile, let's open up tomato, diced tomato. Alright, onion and mushroom look nice and tender. Ready to add diced tomato. Give it a stir. Mmm, smells good. And now I'm going to cook, stirring occasionally for about 10 minutes. While sauce is cooking, I'm going to prepare oregano. Pick the leaves off of the oregano stems. Put on a side. Next, I have olives. Just a smack on it to remove the seed off of the olives, and then just roughly chop them. Let's check the sauce. Looks good. I do not see water anymore. Ready to season with pepper. I already added salt, but if you haven't yet, add salt and pepper at this time, and add oregano leaves. Turn off the stove. Coming back to squash, I'm going to cook squash on a medium heat. Melt butter with 3 tablespoons of water. Add spaghetti. Squash spaghetti. Look at how much spaghetti I got from just one squash. It says for 2 people, but I think I can feed 4 people with this amount of spaghetti. Add salt and pepper, and cook until you don't see water. Also, it says add 1/2 of Parmesan cheese into the spaghetti while cooking, and rest, leave for topping. All right, it looks like there's no water in there. Turn off the stove. Bring down onto the plate. Put some sauce on top and some oregano leaves, and top it up with more Parmesan cheese. Oh yes, don't forget olives.
Look at this. I made the same look as shown in the recipe card. So foolproof recipe.
And time to give it a bite. I still have to prepare 2 more recipes, so just hang around there. Looking at the ingredients, I just thought whether I'm gonna like it or not, but it tastes so yummy. Thanks to Blue Apron for teaching me something new today. For more details, do not forget to check out the link provided under this video description box. The next item on meal menu is mixed mushroom risotto. Now, I have few picky eaters in my house for mushroom, so I'm going to customize this recipe as per my family preference. So you can certainly do recipes as per your preference. Now, since I'm following the recipe card, I'm just going to quickly cook this recipe. But for the detailed recipes, you can always go to blueapron.com. All right, I'm going to put this on the side. Next on a meal menu is kale and monitory jack quesadilla. Yes. Oh, that's kid's favorite and my favorite too. So let's get started.
Shred cheese, wash and remove the stem of kale. Chop kale roughly. Into the same pan I cooked the mushroom risotto. I'm going to add a little bit of oil. Add kale, garlic, spice blend, and a little bit of water. Perfect. Turn off the stove. Radish, which I'm going to cut. You can just cut however you like, but I'm going to julienne cut. Perfect. Avocado. And avocado tends to change color, so make sure to squeeze a little bit of lime juice on top. I'm just going to slice it up. You can just cut however you like and then just scoop it out like so. I'm also going to chop a little bit of cilantro. All right, so here I have cilantro done. Next, it says to prepare Mexican lime crema, or I don't know what it is. Looks like a cream. Here I have this lime squeeze in there. Just give it a stir. Pepper. And a little bit of salt. Mix it well.
All right, all preps are done. And here I got tortillas.
So I'm going to take first two of them. Basically, all I'm going to do is divide the kale mixture between two quesadillas. Next, cheese. Place another tortilla on top of it. Melt butter into the pan. And carefully place the quesadilla and bake until golden brown color on both sides. I can see that cheese has already melted in there, oozing out. So, flip it one more time and I'm going to take it away into the plate.
Now, the original recipe has fried eggs to top it up, but I'm not going to use eggs. So, I'm going to just decorate with the rest of the ingredients that I prepared.
So, here I got radish, just top it up, and avocado, sprinkle, cilantro, lime cream on top. Perfect.
All right, so mission complete. I got roasted squash spaghetti, mushroom risotto, and quesadilla. What could be better than this complete meal menu? So I hope I made it easier for you to try out Blue Apron. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with another great recipe.